Many teachers dream on visiting summer schools in a foreign country. It can be amazing experiences for those who are interested in improving their current work and further professional development. Montse Colomer, Jordi Roca, Anna Canalda, Anna Moron and Ima Vall, we are five different subject teachers in Institut Jaume Callís in the community of Vic, Catalonia. Our school has been involved in several European projects. Last September, we have had the opportunity to take part in a short-term joint staff training event, also known job shadowing. We visited an elementary school in the village Dalby, in the community of Lund. We have been in this place from 28th of August to 2nd of September. We had the chance to meet and work together with Sweden teachers and also with some Italian teachers. Schools are organized in many different ways. Customs and traditions can be a little bit different, and sometimes we were not sure how to deal with it. But to work in a place that is so different to where we are used is really enriching. All of us, we appreciate a lot these experiences. They were really interesting and they had benefited a lot our professional work.
The job shadowing experience was very interesting and rewarding. Before the visit, being in school for a week, just watching seemed to me a good occasion to think about how we realize. However, during the visit, I realized that we could also discuss differences and similarities in school functioning with Catalonian and Swedish maths, and think deeply about our jobs. Not less importantly, the experience allowed us to get to know the Swedish culture by visiting interesting places or eating and drinking delicious Swedish specialties like crayfish, a type of red berries I don't remember the name of, or snaps. Two things about Swedish schools surprised me the most. First of all, each class lasts differently, and students have different rest periods during the day. They can do that because noise in there doesn't exist. This is the thing that surprised me the most. There wasn't any noise on the corridors and of course in the classroom. I think this is due to cultural difference between Mediterranean and Nordic cultures. As a Swedish teacher noted, noise is present in Catalonia not only among the students, but also in the staff room and, of course, in restaurants, public transportation. According to them, everything in our life is noise. Secondly, although Swedish teachers don't seem very strict and authoritarian to me, they don't need to call for attention frequently, as the students behave very commonly. The students could go out of the classroom to get a book or go to the toilets, and without disturbing the class. Here, this seems impossible to share. To conclude, I want to give million thanks to all partners Swedish teachers who made our stay very pleasant, showing us their country and their traditions.
We have two schools and two different countries, but we can compare us with them. One thing which shocked me was the fact that the students use the phone in a free way. But because in our school, they are not allowed to do it. Another one, they don't have computer science as a subject. So, in Catalonia, for example, this is strange. Well, but a positive thing could be that I note that they were very practical. For example, between the classroom, there was another space for sharing with the students and teachers. They came to check works and explain doubts, for example. And one part of the curriculum is related with real life, is the which call home economics, because in this subject the students cooking basic meals, manufacturing, working with wood and wool, and using electrical, for example, at the. Finally, I can decide that this experience was really good for me, and it was better than I could imagine. Well, it's absolutely excellent.
The stay in Dalby last August in the job shadowing program provided us the opportunity to exchange experiences and opinions about how to deal with our duties as teachers and educators. Our Swedish counterparts were so dedicated to us, and over a week, by means of long conversations, we could compare methodologies, levels, subjects, attitudes, and even salaries and working conditions. As I see it, be conscious about our differences and similarities is absolutely interesting and useful in order to enlarge our skills to improve our job. Fortunately, the weather was pretty warm, sunny and pleasant, and enabled us to go on sightseeing around Lund, Malmö, and many beautiful small villages near the seashore.
I think job shadowing was a great opportunity for me to know something else about other European educational systems, to see how far or close it is to what I am doing in my daily job, and to find out the coincidences and the differences between the Swedish school and our school in Vik. I also was expecting to know about different methodologies, ideas, or activities the teachers are using in the Dalby school, and to take advantage of them in my own lessons with my students. About the worries I would have had before we visited the Swedish school, I didn't have any. As the teacher who hosted me was the teacher I hosted in our school in Vik in February 2016. Finally, I think my expectations have been fulfilled. I learned about the educational system of Sweden. I saw all the teaching styles and methodologies. It was a chance to think over how I can improve in my teaching job.
Senzill d'entendre, la porta espera oberta.